Hey everyone, this is Craze, and welcome to my latest video on Skillcapped. For those of you who don't know me, I'm a European priest who has actively been contributing for Skillcapped for the last 2 years. Currently I'm rank 1 in all brackets, and the 5th highest rated player in the world. Today I'm going to go over how exactly you want to be playing priest in 2-on-2. Okay, now to start us off, I just want to talk about our strengths and weaknesses as a priest, so we can really get an idea of the kind of spells that we're going to be looking at, and how to really utilize our strengths and be wary of our weaknesses, so we don't get caught off guard too often. Okay, so the advantages that priest has over some of the other healers in 2s is the fact that we have a strong amount of CC. You know, you've got fear, which is really powerful for a healer, and then you can mind control as well. A lot more in 2-on-2 than say the other brackets. Mind control actually becomes a pretty big deal in 2s, just because you take less damage and there's less people to interrupt you and things like that. We also have a high amount of longevity, you know, things like Rapture, keeping your mana up very well. You can even get away with going haste gear in 2s quite comfortably. Mana burn is pretty unique in the game now, I guess. You know, you can control the other healer's mana pretty well if you set up good burns, and usually have a mana advantage in most games, unless you're meeting another priest and they get more burns off, for example. And also, priests have spammable damage, so when you're going for a kill or so, you know, you can spam Mind Spikes, Mind Blast, Holy Fire, Shadow of Death, Shadow Fiend, and even Dots. So, you know, those kind of things really make priests powerful in 2s, but, you know, that doesn't come without their weaknesses. Okay, now in general, priests are definitely the strongest healer in 2s right now, in my opinion. But, you know, that doesn't come without some weaknesses. So the weaknesses that I think that priest has at the moment in 2s is, number one, you're very vulnerable to getting trained for a long period of time. So say if your teammate leaves a warrior on you for a couple of minutes or even less, and you know you don't have some cooldowns for a throwdown or something, then you can die there easily. You're quite vulnerable to getting trained by 2 DPS as well. You know, if a red DK goes on you and they actually connect, then you can die very, very quickly. So you need a healthy amount of pills and good coordination to counteract that, for sure. You also have to cast quite often when healing heavily. You know, priest has to cast more than any other healer in the game, I think, when they have to heal a lot. So, you know, whereas a shaman would have Earth Shield and Riptide and things, you know, once your shield and prayer mending are down, you know, you have to start casting, and if you keep faking, then your teammate or yourself is just gonna die. So you have to play really smart with that, and that's a weakness that priest has, especially if there's a lot of interrupts to get through. And upon that, you're quite cooldown reliant when tanking damage. You know, to tank stuns and things, you will need like a pain suppression or a inner focus or a power barrier or something to be quite safe. But if you don't have any cooldowns for, you know, a big nuke and a stun or a silence, then you know, you are quite vulnerable to dying through that for sure. Okay, so moving on to the games now. Every game that you actually see in this video is only part of a 6 games frapsed folder. You know, only frapped 6 games for this video. You know, isn't a super hand-picked, you know, clips where I do amazing things. You know, this is just everyday rank 1 level play that I'm going to talk you guys through. So, you know, on this opener, the first thing to notice is that we're against the Rogue Mage and I'm playing Priest Mage. As you can see here, I actually de-clicked my Fear Ward right away. You know, I cancel ordered it because I don't want the mage to spell still Fear Ward if they get a Snap Opener on me. You know, it's not worth having that as a trash buff at all in case it gets spell stolen. Another thing to point out is that I'm stacking Grace on myself right away preemptively. So if they open on me, then I already have my Grace stacks right away, so I can get that extra healing. So at the start of the game, you generally want to think about who they're going to go on first and then stack Grace on them preemptively. If you want more information on general healing, then you can check out my How to Heal video on Skillcapped, where it goes over all the healing rotations and what spells to use and when. Okay, so in this game, hurling over the rogue out of stealth as I get sapped, which is pretty lucky, but you always want to spam like Mindseer and Holy Novas and things at the start to try and de-stealth enemy rogues or even druids. They open up on my mage and put a ring around her, so I decide to stay in this ring and use my Aura Mastery very early, so I can't get interrupted by my spells and I can't get an early blanket CS on me. And I want to keep him on a good amount of HP right now. Now, the great thing about Priest against double DPS is that Priest is really good at single target healing, and you have a lot of cooldowns to really counter the pressure. So I fake counterspell here, but that naturally puts me into a blanket counterspell. So I use my Power Infusion for faster heals, so I can keep my mage up throughout all this opening pressure. You never really want to hold on to your Power Infusion too long at the start of a game as a Priest, especially in 2-on-2, if you really want to make the most out of that spell. Now, another job which Priest has in twos is to actively use your fears. I didn't want to fear the rogue of this Polly because we called a switch onto him. So I'm just saving my fear for now until later. I fade the counterspell again, and this was good communication with my mage because he interrupted the polymorph as I got blanket counterspelled. As obviously I can't shadow a death when I'm silenced. Okay, now here's a really important moment in the game. It's recognizing when you don't have to heal that much anymore and you can go offensive. Now, in this case, it's quite obvious because the game is pretty much over their blast, right? But the fact that you know that they're not going to be aiming for a kill on your mage now means you can go out full offensive and help your teammate go for a kill, no matter what comp you're playing. So in this case, I start throwing out some holy fires, offensive dispels. I keep my teammate out of crowd control, and then I use my master spell on the ice block. And that's a really great thing about Priest in twos, is that once you're done healing, you can easily switch to a really offensive kind of playstyle with that spammable damage that I was talking about, and crowd control with the fears and the mind controls and things. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys another short double DPS clip where I just want to highlight the effectiveness of fearing and system with damage and things like that. So I run with the fear here. Now, this is what you call an effective fear. That's because I got both targets at the same time. It's not always necessary to get a double fear all the time in twos. Sometimes it's great to just fear one DPS as you stun their healer or something and then get mana burns and things like that. But against double DPS, you always want to look for effective fearing to give your teammates some breathing room. Now, because they have double trinket here, they both decide to trinket my fear, which is great, but you know that they're going to be wanting to put some pressure out now because I've just used their trinket. So now that I've feared them and they've trinketed, our goal is to survive until the next fear. That's how important fear is. It's really great for peeling for your teammate and allowing you guys to actually get some damage out and some pressure. But for now, I got their trinkets with the first fear, so I want the second fear to be really effective as well. Now, they start popping all their cooldowns on my mage due to just trinketing. They know that they have a short amount of time now to get some pressure out. So I match that with an inner focus and a power infusion heal on my mage, but the red actually hodges me. Now, the reason why I trinketed the hodge there was because my mage didn't have a power word shield up. So when you pain suppression your mage without a power word shield, and they have a hunter and a ret on them, they're going to have to block anyway. The PS doesn't matter. So you don't want to overlap those two. If I could have shielded and then PS, then it could have been fine. But because I couldn't, I decided to trinket the hodge, and then when the hunter came over, I shadow melded to clear his focus of me and try to get some heals up before my mage has to block. And then after the block, I just PS my mage right away, to try and keep him offensive. And then I'm able to get my second fear off, which basically ends the game because I didn't have that trinket for it. Now, as I get that second fear off, we can go really offensive on the hunter now. So we put a deep freeze on him, and then I use my Shadow Fiend and start bursting with my mage. You can see how quickly this hunter drops now. He dies instantly in the deep freeze. And that's the kind of power that Priest has, that you can fear and then you can help your partner assist in damage and really get some pressure rolling. Okay, now in this game we're against the Aristo Shaman Shadow Priest. We're about halfway into the match, and as you can see in this situation, the Shadow Priest uses his unused trinket and wings, so he's looking to put out some pressure on us right now. So he has an offensive position here, but if you can see, I'm max ranging the Shaman, so I can get some burns on the priest without getting shocked. So you know, this is just a correct positioning that I took that allowed me to get quite a few burns before the Shaman came out and shocked me. So you know, if you want more information on how to position yourself correctly, I have a positioning guide on skill capped, and I'm gonna make a few more very soon. So definitely check that out. So, because I'm max ranging the Shaman, I can freely burn this priest to Oom, and we can go back on the offensive now, you know, he's not a real threat anymore. Okay, so I continue to mana burn this priest to Oom, and then follow that up with the Mind Control. If you notice here, I shielded myself so I could get a quicker cast on the Mind Control with my borrowed time. He then trinkets into a full fear, which his Shaman has to use another global and dispelling. Now, because we know that the priest is so Oom, as I just feared a Shadow Fiend as well, you know, he's not going to be able to off-heal or Master Spell his Shaman right now. So we decide to go ahead and set up a Deep Freeze Nuke onto the Shaman. So I've just gone from, you know, building up some momentum for our team by, you know, spamming mana burns and things, to now going really offensive on the Shaman. So I decide to use a Power Infusion here so that I can assist with damage with this Deep Freeze. And as you can see, the Shaman drops to about 4k HP before he Spirit Links. So we have a ton of momentum now, and you know, we can continue to build up this pressure throughout the game. Okay, now this priest tries to get a burn on me. I Shadow Mold it, and then I actually let this priest run up to me for the fear, because I wanted to get a fear on him. You know, I knew I could ward that fear and then just fear him off it. If I didn't want to fear the priest, then I would have just kited away, as that would be more efficient, but I wanted to fear ward the fear so I can get the fear on the priest, so we can continue, you know, this pressure on the Shaman. Now, because this priest is you know, really screwed on mana already, I just decided to, you know, burn him through everything basically, and then we just train the Shaman. Now, when this priest comes up to me around now, I decide to get another fear on him as we deep freeze the Shaman, and then I switch to damage on the Shaman, but my mage cools that he's not going to be able to do that much to him, so then I switch to mana burns, and then my mage puts some small CCs on the Shaman so he can't move away from the burns. So now we've got them both, you know, really low in mana, and you know, they really have no chance of winning anymore. So we just go hard in the Shaman with the poly on the priest right here, and then I decide to mind control him out of the poly just so he can't help his Shaman anymore, and then, you know, I could fear off that and things like that. So, you know, it's just really important to understand when to assist your teammate with pressure, when to, you know, really focus on avoiding CC. For example, if they have some pressure up, then you don't want to run in for an offensive fear and get you feared yourself or something like that. And, you know, just generally helping out your teammate and adjusting to that playstyle. You know, when they're nuking, you know, hopefully you can nuke as well. And then when they're controlling the enemy team, you can follow up that CC with a fear or mind control. So, you know, that's the kind of playstyle that you really want to go for in 2-on-2. Okay, now to summarize this video, things to keep in mind is that you want to adjust your playstyle to your teammates' play. You know, whether that's offensively or defensively, you know, just play to support them, basically. You want to use your cooldowns to help out with that, so if they're going for, you know, a really bursty nuke, you could use your Shadow Fiend, Power Infusion, you know, things to deal damage with. Don't hesitate to ask your teammates to assist you. For example, if you want to get a burns on a Shaman and you play with a Rogue, you know, you ask him, can you kidney shot soon? He says yes, you fear the DPS, you use your Power Infusion and you start mana burning, you know, when he gets kidney shot, so you can't ground or shock. And you always want to look for ways to improve your goal. So if your game plan was to kill a mage, for example, in a mage priest mirror, and you were trying to burn the priest so he can't heal, for example, you know, you should think to yourself, well, if I just dispelled the mage, you know, offensively purging and got more crowd control, then, you know, we could have had a much easier time killing them. So always look for ways to improve your gameplay, and until then, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.